This video is sponsored by RKDF University, Radisson Blue.
The BCCI is unlikely to send the Indian men's team to Pakistan in 2025 for the ICC Champions Trophy. Sources indicate that the BCCI plans to request the ICC to relocate the venue, with Dubai or Sri Lanka being potential alternatives. A key match between India and Pakistan is set for March 1 in Lahore. Prime Minister Modi wrapped up his visits to Russia and Austria on Thursday and returned to India. During his trip, he focused on bolstering ties with the two nations and engaged in discussions with their leaders on critical global issues. Since 2010, India's average yearly wealth growth has more than halved, according to UBS Global Wealth Report 2024. The report reveals that India's compound annual growth rate expanded about 7% from 2010 to 2023, a stark decline from the approximately 14% growth observed from 2000 till 2010. Weeks after informed that the parts of purported skeleton of murder victim Sheena Bora were untraceable, the prosecution has told the trial court here that they were lying at the CBI's office in New Delhi. A video has captured the moment where the American Airlines flight's tire burst into flames as the plane was taking off from the runway at Tampa Airport. The video shows that the American Airlines plane taxiing on the runway when its tire catches fire and smoke fills the air. Indian origin Shivani Raja has become the first Conservative MP to win the Leicester City seat in 37 years. This victory was marked by a symbolic oath-taking ceremony on July 10th, where she swore her allegiance to the UK Parliament on the sacred Bhagavad Gita. The Supreme Court on July 18th adjourned hearing a batch of petition alleging irregularities and malpractices in the conduct of the medical entrance exam NEET UG 2024 to July 18th. A bench headed by the CJI D.Y. Chandrachoor deferred the hearing at the request of petitioner's lawyers, who asked for additional time to pursue the affidavits filed by the center and the National Testing Agency. An association of Goa hotels and travel businesses has opposed the move to introduce the Goa Tourism Promotion, Management and Regulation Bill, saying that it will kill the industry. The proposed legislation seeks to replace the Goa Tourist Trade Act 1984. Security agencies have seized yet another Pakistan-bound consignment consisting of international banned chemicals used for tear gas and riot control agents from China at a port in Tamil Nadu, officials said here on Thursday. The Delhi government on Thursday increased pollution under check PUC certificate charges after 13-year gap. This development came after Delhi Petrol Dealers Association put forward a request to hike the charges.
इस तरह RKDF विश्वविद्यालय राज्य और देश के आधुनिक और उच्च विश्वविद्यालयों में से एक है।
RKDF University, ये है RKDF
University, a world class university, education glorifies nation.
Supreme Court Judge Sanjay Kumar on Thursday opted out of hearing the pleas of AAP leader and former Delhi Deputy Chief Minister Manish Sisodia, by which his bail petition had been sought to be revived in the liquor policy scam. Royal expert Hilary Fordwich reveals that Prince William views himself as the family enforcer and asserts he is the most unlikely royal to ever forgive Harry. Despite King Charles III's desire of reconciliation, Prince William reportedly refuses to engage his brother Harry. US President Joe Biden will Thursday give his first press conference since his debate disaster against Donald Trump in a pressure cooker moment that could seal the fate of his re-election bid. China is staging army drill with Belarus this week at NATO's eastern border in a sign of escalating tensions between Beijing and the US-led defense alliance. On July 11, a Saudi Airlines flight from Riyadh caught fire as it touched down the Peshawar airport. Air traffic controllers noticed smoke coming from the left landing gear and promptly alerted rescue crews. Saudi Airlines confirmed the incident, stating that the smoke from a tire was observed during the landing flight SV-792. NATO leaders have pledged to provide Ukraine with at least $43 billion in military aid within the next year to bolster its defense against Russia, and formally declared Kyiv on the irreversible path to membership in the Western Military Alliance. The Worli police investigation, the BMW hit and run case involving Mihir Shah, son of Shiv Sena leader Rajesh Shah, informed a court on Thursday that he and his driver had bought beer from a Malad bar and drank it inside the car after leaving a Juhu bar where he had alcohol with his friends. Lightning strike claimed over 30 lives in Uttar Pradesh, with Pratapgarh recording the highest toll of 11 deaths, followed by Sultanpur with 7, Chandoli with 6, Mainpuri with 5 and Prayagraj with 4. Many others have suffered burn injuries as well. Former House Speaker Nancy Pelosi addressed the ongoing speculation about President Joe Biden's candidacy on Wednesday, stating, "It's up to the president to decide if he should remain in the race." China is a decisive enabler of Russia's war against Ukraine, NATO leaders said on Wednesday as the defense alliance hardens its stance on Beijing and the systematic challenges they say it poses to their country's security.